We are in the sensory system. Scientists in the sensory system like to show you this picture. This is your five senses, and that's your brain. And they usually say, you believe you know this world pretty well, but everything is created, an illusion created by your brain. Sounds creepy, and the reason they say that is because your brain, we spend a lot of time talking about this, and it's well protected inside, it's put into your skull. And inside the brain, it never actually touched the outside world, so it does not see the light, does not see the sound. So all you have is action potential, is your five senses. They transfer the physical stimulus and into different intensity, duration of action potential. And it's not easy to do because you know the action potential is all or one, all or none, is all the same size. So we're going to talk about how they're able to code the outside, the different kind of physical stimulus into the action potential and transfer to the brain. And your brain uses those action potential to recreate your sensation. So your sensation comes from the brain created. And this picture, okay, it helps us to understand what's going on, right? So we talk about the brain, your spinal cord, part of your central nervous system, is both of them are well protected inside. And they never touch the outside world. So your sensory system, their job is to pick up the outside physical stimulus, the sound, the light, the touch, the temperature, all the physical stimulus, and transfer them to the central nervous system. And the signal can travel for long distance, is action potential. So they have to transfer all the physical stimulus into action potential and transfer them into the central nervous system. So all your brain have is action potential. And your brain not just stay there to make you feel happy. Your brain has very important job to do, is to keep you alive. So you, every living organism, their purpose of the central nervous system is the same, to keep them alive for as long as possible, so they have a higher chance to pass their gene to next generation, because no one lives forever, and we call the selfish gene. So for the genes, their purpose is to pass the gene to next generation. So your brain wants to increase your chance to survive. That's why they connect to the outside. So through the cranial nerve, through the spinal nerve, we talk about the spinal cord. The dorsal part is the sensory input, and the ventral part is the motor output. That's this part. You're going to go out, control your skeletal muscle through the motor neuron, use acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter, or control your autonomic nervous system. We will talk about this part in next lecture. And it controls the smooth muscle and cardiac muscle. So today we're going to focus on this part, your sensory system. You have five senses. And these five senses can be divided into the general and special. So the general, your skin is a big input. Your skin is not a piece of paper. If I cut your skin peeled open, it's 2 meter by 2 meter square. It weighs about 4 kilograms. So that's the biggest organ you have in your body. It's not a piece of paper. You have a lot of sensor on your skin. The temperature, and temperature can be divided into the hot and cold, the touch, the pressure, the pain, and also he has a lot of gland, the oil gland, sebaceous gland, called the oil gland, and the pseudorectiferous gland, the sweat gland. So your skin has a lot of function. So the skin is a big input of the general sense. General sense, it covers the whole body, but not just the skin, also from the inside, like you tore your ligament, your joint hurt, or your appendix hurt, from the inside also belong to this part. And you have the spatial senses. All this in human, they are in the head. So you have four spatial senses. The eyes, we're going to spend a lot of time talking about the visual. That's our main system. And that's also the most well understood system, sensory system. And then auditory, the ear, and two chemical senses. And let's look at the receptor. The sensory receptors can be put into the simple, complex, and spatial senses. So all these four we just talk about, visual, auditory, and two chemical senses, olfactory, gustatory, they have these kind of spatial senses. And your skin, you have the simple and complex. Let's look at the simple and complex. The simple is you only have one cell. You only have one cell. So these cells have the input part and the output part. So their job is to transfer the signal from the skin and to your central nervous system. They don't have any spatial structure in the input part. So we call the free nerve ending. A good example, the pain sensor. The pain sensor is the simple receptor. It's a free nerve ending one. When you damage your tissue release chemical signal, and this chemical signal will be picked up by the free nerve ending. And it will send a signal, generate action potential, and go to your brain, so you feel the pain. And that's the simple receptor. Let's look at the complex receptor. Complex receptor, still one cell, but the structure is more complicated. They have a receptor part, a spatial structure, like the postcinial capsule. That's the one sense the touch, the pressure. Actually, postcinial capsule is the pressure. So the pressure and touch, they are different sensor. So they have a sensor part, and when you press your skin, the sensor part can be activated. And when you see the axon, you find, oh, it's myelinated, it's faster. So you can quickly sense your body being touched. And that's the complex receptor. Now let's look at the spatial senses. Your four different spatial senses, they all belong to this. And you found a big difference. Two cells. They have one, it's not just a receptor part. They have spatial cells dedicated to transfer the physical stimulus into different level of depolarization than neurotransmitter release. We all talk about this in the neuron part. So they can cause depolarization and they can cause neurotransmitter release. Advantage, now different level of stimulus can easily be transferred into different level of depolarization and can be correlated to different level of neurotransmitter release. Then you have a second cell, usually it's called the ganglia cell. Its job is to pick up the neurotransmitter and transfer them into the action potential, because only the action potential can travel for long distance and send the signal to the brain. So you have at least two. When we talk about the visual system, on your retina, you actually have three. And there's a reason they need to use three, because the rods and cones, the photoreceptor, they don't follow the traditional rule. They use their different rules. So you need to have a bipolar cell to transfer them back. So at least have two. That's the spatial senses. Let's look at the receptor field. Receptor field, the way I explain the receptor field is I use the digital camera. So 10 years ago, when we start to have digital camera, we have those very low resolution one, and each pixel is big. So it turned out the resolution is low. Okay, it's like the large receptor field. Like this surface area, you only put 3 pixels. So each pixel is big. It's like those low resolution digital camera. Resolution is low because each pixel covers a big area. And nowadays, we have those super expensive digital camera, those Canon 5D something. I did not track that. So those high pixel digital camera, each pixel is small, so the resolution is high. And receptive field is like this. So on different body parts, your whole body are not equally high resolution. We actually talk about that in the somatosensory cortex. So you found you have more neurons analyze information from the face, from the finger, yes. And on your skin part, the face and finger, they have small receptive field. So each neuron only cover a very small area. And compare with the back, your body, you only have small amount of neurons cover this area. And turn out each neuron have to cover a big area. So this is the low resolution big pixel. This is the high resolution small pixel. And let's see why they are able to have higher resolution. It turned out those small pixel one, small receptor field. Now we go to the sensor receptor field. Small receptor field. Say you have the two sharp point, and we actually have this in the physiology lab. We use this to test your threshold. So you can move those two small pin and touch different body part. Turn out you touch the green and the purple one. So each one have one neuron send a signal to the brain. And because each neuron cover a very small receptor field, and also it's a very small convergence. We talk about the convergence divergence in the central nervous system. So when the neuron pass the signal from the peripheral to the center, they can have two, three different neurons in between eventually go to the brain. So they can have a high convergence or have low convergence. Like this one is a low convergence, so it's almost one-to-one. So when you go to the brain, it's still one-to-one. And when you go to send the signal to the brain, all the brain have is action potential. So when you activate these two parts, it's this neuron and this neuron generate action potential. And all your brain have is action potential. So your brain know, okay, different neurons generate action potential. And it's different part being touched. So that's the small receptive field, low convergence, equal to high resolution. Now let's look at this one. This one, each receptive field is big. And when they send a signal to the second layer, to the third neuron, they converge a lot. So like you touch these two points, the same distance, you touch these two points, and it starts with the green and the purple one. When they send the signal to the brain, it converges. So it turns out it's the same neuron generate action potential. Because all your brain have is action potential. And when you look back and say, well, this neuron generate action potential when this part being touched, and this the same neuron generate action potential when the purple part being touched, and your brain have no way to tell it's different part being touched. Your brain gonna feel like, okay, it's one point being touched. And that's the low resolution. And this happens in your back, in your insensitive body part. When we do this experiment in the physiology lab, we can take this small equipment and move a small distance, touch your back, and you feel like the subject can report, oh, I feel like one point being touched. And we use the same distance, touch the face, touch the lips, and the subject can say, I feel like there are two points being touched, because these are the sensitive body part with high resolution, and because they have small receptive field, and they have low convergence. So the big receptive field, high convergence, equal to low resolution. And why your brain have to do this? Because we just could not afford to make the whole body part equally sensitive. So we have to pick some body part, make them very sensitive. That's your lips, that's your face, that's your finger. And the other body parts, make them not so sensitive, but they can still detect something. So like your back, this is a low resolution area, high resolution area. Okay, let's take a break.